Now, we are asked in this problem, in this challenge, to actually work out the missing pronumeral, which is the angle down here on the ground. I'm going to read the question for you. We'll read it together. It's a tree 21 meters tall, as I said, here it is, casts a shadow 29 meters long. That's a massive shadow there. That's beautiful there on a hot summer's day. What angle do the sun's rays, there's the sun coming down here, make with the ground? So this is the angle, the pronumeral. Theta, that's what we're looking for. Okay, now the clues are in the question, and as you look at this question, you might ask yourself, what have I got? Because that's the best question you can ask if you ever get a problem. What have I got? Let's have a look at it. What have I got? Well, I've got the height, 21 meters. I've got the shadow, 29 meters. And we have this missing pronumeral here. We know it's a right angle triangle because we're assuming it's flat ground. So let's write down now what we want to find, and the first step is to find which trig ratio is it. Now, based on what we have, is it a sine, is it a cos, or is it a tan? If it's a tan, it's pretty hard to get a tan if you're in the shade, but it could be a tan. Let's check this out. We have, first of all, here in front, from the theta, going directly opposite, right here, 21 meters. So what's that going to be? Obviously, it's a opposite. That's part of the trig ratio. And then right next to it, because the angle is attached to the ground, right here is the 29 meters. What's that going to be right next to it? It's called ADJ, and you know that's adjacent, isn't it? So we have opposite over adjacent. Let's write that up. Now, which of the three ratios is it? Sine, cos, or tan? Tan, I hear from you. So let's put that in. That's good news. It is a tan. So tan theta equals opposite over adjacent, which equals what numbers do we have? You ask that question again. What have I got? Looking at the diagram, I have the opposite right across here, 21 meters. Let's put that in. All over adjacent, right down here on the shadow, 29 meters. Okay, cool. Now, let's continue. Let's go. Tan theta equals, now on the calculator, I like to turn it into a decimal, but if you prefer to keep it as a fraction, that's fine. 21 divided by 29 as a decimal is 0.724. Let's write that in. 0.724. Okay, now we want to get the theta by itself right here. So let's put that here. Now, the way to do that is we inverse tan on both sides, or shift tan if you prefer. So that means we have on the right-hand side now, tan inverse, that little power to negative 1 means shift or inverse, and then we have 0.724 in there. Now we can put that in the calculator, so it's shift tan or second function tan, 0.724, and that will yield a decimal degree. So theta equals, putting that in there, 35.9097 degrees. That's a decimal degree. That's not minutes and seconds. It's a decimal degree. 35.9097 degrees. Now, let's change it into degrees, minutes, seconds. Well, put it in the calculator again, and you go shift DMS, or shift, you know, those two quote degrees, minutes, seconds, and you will get 35 degrees, 54 minutes, and the seconds I'll write in blue, and the seconds are 35 seconds. Now, let's take a look. Do we climb up or do we stay down? This is the big question here. We have 54 minutes. Let's get it to the nearest minute. Now, 54, 35. Notice the 35 is above 30. And if it's above 30, what do we do with the minutes? We go up. So, therefore, to the nearest minute, the answer for that angle there on the ground, the sun's rays coming down is 35 degrees and 55 minutes.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.